morning, students. Welcome back. Today, we will discuss chapter 2. Its name is Self and Personality. This chapter carries a weightage of 10 marks from board's point of view. Let's look at the concept of self firstly. Now, self basically addresses the question of who am I? If I have to describe about myself, that is what myself is. That is the image I carry about myself is my concept of self. Let's look at the definition. Self-concept is defined as the totality of individuals, thoughts and feelings having reference to him or her as an object. Lifestyle in many ways is an outward expression of one's self-concept. So what do you think about yourself? The total experiences, total thoughts, the total ideas about whom you think you are is known as self. Now, how does it develop? It basically develops from your interaction with significant people in your life, your parents, your friends, your neighbors, your relatives, your teacher. All these are important people in your life. If they tell something, it stays on with you. And you start thinking in that direction. Am I like that? Why they keep mentioning about me like that? So all that impression stays on with you. You organize that experience about who you are. So let's look at that. The dual state of self. First, self as a subject, self as an object. As a subject, it's about the actor that you are, the doer, the knower. That means if I say I'm a good dancer, that is about the actor that I am, or the subject of the self. And as an object, the consequence, known, thought, feeling. If I say I got hurt, that is which is an object, feeling, consequence, the known. So these are according to subject and object. Next is kinds of self. Kinds of self has two major kinds, personal self, social self. Personal self lays emphasis on those aspects of life that are only concerns to the person. For example, personal freedom, personal responsibility, personal achievement, personal comfort in relation to himself. Social, family, relational self. We use three names for same concept. We emphasize is here on social aspects of life. For example, cooperation, unity, attachment with other people, compromising for other people and sharing for other people. Next is kinds of identity. Here is, first is personal identity. Second is social identity. We have again same kinds of identity like self. Personal identity. If someone asks you your name, then it's a personal identity. If somebody asks you about your quality, that is also personal identity. So attributes and quality of person that make him or her different from others, that are personal. And social identity, who am I in context of society? Am I North Indian? Am I North Indian? Am I Hindu? That is my link to my culture and social group. So let's move on to behavioral and cognitive aspect. Here is aspects of self. First is cognitive aspect and second is behavioral aspect. Cognitive aspect includes two concepts, self-concept and self-esteem. Here is self-concept is basically an image that I carry about myself. I am a good poet, I am a good at maths, I am good at sports, I am average in other areas. That is self-concept. The other is self-esteem. Esteem basically means your worthiness. Do I value myself? Do I think I am capable? My judgment about my own self is known as self-esteem. So, it develops through four areas. It talks about four areas: social competence, cognitive competence, physical appearance and physical competence. These four areas will start development right from the 7 years of age. So this is about self-esteem. Next time we will continue with behavioral aspects.